Welcome to Top Crew Aviation. This is Captain P.K. Yadav.
Hello guys, as we all know, we have done startup, we have done pushback, we have done with the ATC clearance, taxi, how to take departure clearance. We know how to give position report. Today we would discuss the new topic, which is RVSM. So first we would understand what is RVSM, why do we need it, and what are the benefits, and what would be the requirement if any aircraft wants to fly in RVSM, guys. Alright, so we would understand, first of all, the full form of RVSM is Reduced Vertical Separation Minimum. Alright guys, so what is RVSM? Why do we need it? Before that guys, I would like to tell you, there were earlier, we used to say this CVSM, that was Conventional Vertical Separation Minimum. CVSM stands for Conventional Vertical Separation Minimum. In that, above flight level 290, guys, we take the separation of 2000 feet. So why this is reduced? Because we have reduced the separation that has been 1000 feet from 2000 feet. That is why now we have some additional flight levels. That's why we call this reduced vertical separation minimum. We do not follow conventional vertical separation minimum now, because with the CVSM we had a limited number of flight levels, because we need to give the separation of 2000 feet. Alright, in opposite direction, in case of same direction, guys, we need to give them separation of 4000 feet. Now we are giving the separation just half whatever we were giving earlier. That is why we called it reduced vertical separation. If you count from 290, so what are the flight levels between 290 to 410? If you check, if you calculate like 290, then 310, then 330, then 350, then 370, then 390, and guys 410. So you just have five flight levels that can be assigned in between. But after applying RVSM, guys, six more flight levels have been added. So you do have in total 13 level can be assigned, guys. So we always, whenever A aircraft coming from east and B aircraft is coming from west, then if we are giving separation of 1000 in RVSM, in case A and B both are coming from east, guys, then our separation would be double, that would be 2000 feet. So I hope you understand with the help of this picture which is on the screen right now, that is explaining you like how RVSM or CVSM assigned the flight levels for the pilots and how they were flying using these conventional as well as reduced vertical separation minimum, guys. So as I described, guys, a program was initiated by ICAO in 1982, involving worldwide studies to assess the feasibility of a reduction of vertical separation minimum. Alright guys, above flight level 290 from 2000 feet to 1000 feet. Why? Because we know the aviation is booming and passengers are increasing every day. We definitely need more space, more flight levels, more airports, more aircraft and more pilots. So this was the one of the requirements. So, ICAO assessed the feasibility, alright, and finally they introduced this and applied across the globe, alright. So reduced vertical separation minimum is defined as the reduction of vertical space between aircraft from 2000 to 1000 feet at flight levels from flight level 290 to flight level 410, guys. And do remember, above flight level 410, separation would be minimum 2000 feet, that's for sure. And how we can reduce, like just a simple question, how we can reduce and why we were using 2000 feet separation. So basic answer is, guys, due to pressure change above flight level 290 is more. So we cannot rely on one instrument. So I'll tell you, like, if we have reduced, you know, the level, then definitely we have something backup in mind. So next thing is, guys, RVSM was implemented as a means to increase airspace capacity, as I told you, and provide access to more fuel efficient flight levels. So that's self-explanatory, guys. The principal benefit, what was the principal benefit? As we have already discussed, guys, a theoretical doubling of the airspace capacity between 290 to 410. So now the opportunity for aircraft to operate at closer to the optimum flight levels with the resulting fuel economies, guys, right? So definitely, like, we need not to go to 2000 feet. In place of 2000 feet, if we are maintaining just 1000 feet separation, definitely it is going to be cost effective for us, alright? So guys, between 1997 and 2005, RVSM was implemented in all of Europe, North Africa, Southeast Asia, North America, South America, and over the North Atlantic and Pacific Oceans, guys. So overall, like between 97 to 2005, it was implemented across the globe. In case of any query, guys, just do let me know. I'm here to help you. You can comment below too, and I'll give you the response. All right, guys. So take care. See you soon. Bye-bye.
Here you go, your checklist. Like, subscribe, and share. Thank you for watching.